Joining us now to discuss, producer of the film Sound of Freedom, Eduardo Verástegui. Thank you so much for being with us today. It's a pleasure to have you.
Thank you so much. It's an honor for me to be here with you.
Absolutely. So, Eduardo, what inspired you to want to be a part of this production?
I met Tim Ballard and his friends, ex-Navy SEALs, ex-FBI agents in Los Angeles, California, 8 years ago. When I learned what they were doing, traveling around the world undercover, rescuing children who were kidnapped for sex exploitation, and when they explained to me in details what happened to these children, 5, 6, 7 year old children who are being raped 10 to 15 times a day for many years. And after that, they opened them, some of them, and they sell their organs. I was in shock. I couldn't sleep. And I remember when Tim Butler looked at me and he saw my face and he told me, Eduardo, it's very sad what I'm telling you. But brother, now that you know it, it's more sad that now that you know it, if you do nothing, what are you going to do? And at that moment, I knew that I had to do something about it. You know, I asked myself, I asked God, what can I do? I'm a filmmaker. I have a weapon of mass instruction and inspiration. I'm going to make a movie. Movies move people, movie to movement. So we need to create a movement. And that's why we started this. This is not just a movie, this is a movement. Because when I asked Tim Ballard, how come if the United States of America is the most powerful country in the world, you guys have the money, the intelligence, technology, army, police, everything. How come we don't finish this problem? And Tim looked at me and he said, because it's not priority. It's not a priority. How can we turn this into priority? We need a movement. We need to bring everyone together. And I hope this movie will be that instrument, that piece, important piece that will raise awareness and bring people together, put pressure in government so it can be a priority. And I have no doubt that if we work together, we will end this nightmare because God's children are not for sale.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm so, so grateful that you're shedding light on this critically important issue that not nearly enough people are talking about. Something absolutely must be done. So hopefully this starts waking people up. Now, I know this film is based on a true story. Can you tell us more about Tim Ballard and Operation Underground Railroad?
So when I met Tim and I wanted to make a movie about his life, so, he has traveled the world, you know, he has been involved in hundreds of rescue missions. And I told him, there's no way I'm going to be able to tell your life story in one movie. I need a TV series for, you know, maybe 200 episodes. So tell me which rescue mission has been the most difficult one, the most dangerous one, the most successful one. And he said, wow. Without a question, the first one, Cartagena, Colombia. Well, tell me the story. And he told me the story, and then I asked him, you know, how the story ended, how the story ended. And he said, well, you know, when we rescued these children, they were crying, they were in tears, they were singing, they were celebrating their freedom. It was like this beautiful sound of freedom. And I said, that's the story, and that's the title of this movie. And we invested 8 years of our lives, 8 years of work for 2 hours of your time, and I hope this movie will touch your heart. It's coming out July 4th, and I picture this. This is the first thing I did so I can focus on this mission, because I put pause in everything that I was doing so I can dedicate my life to this mission, which is to end child trafficking. And I said, okay, what if this is my son? What would I do? Yeah. I will stop everything that I'm doing, and I will hope the entire world will stop everything they're doing so they can help me to find my child. So that's my motivation. I've been waking up every day with that motivation. And I don't have to wait. You don't have to wait to this tragedy to come to your house to wake up.
Yeah.
We need to wake up now. Because if we don't do something now, the pain of these children sooner or later will reach out to all of us. And then we will be living a nightmare that is going to be very hard to wake up if we wouldn't do something now.
That's so true. And it's just so devastating that so many people write this off or think that it's some crazy, far-fetched conspiracy when it's happening every single day in our own country. Why do you think it is that society as a whole is not focused on this bipartisan issue?
You know, a lot of people, they don't know about this problem, or they don't want to know about this problem because it's horrible. And I didn't know 8 years ago. I mean, I knew about human trafficking, generally speaking, but I didn't know with details about child trafficking for sexual exploitation and organs traffic. So there's a lot of people that, like me before, they don't know.
For all our viewers asking where One America News is heading in the future, we would like to introduce you to OAN Live. OAN Live is the best way to stay up to date on all of the hard-hitting, straight-shooting, national and international headlines. And the best part is, OAN Live is only $4.99 per month. All the credible, honest, unbiased reporting One America News offers at a fraction of the cost of cable. Just go to OANN.com to easily sign up for OAN Live and stay informed.